Alternatives to failed PRP at age 20. I'm 20, started thinning around 16. I've lost a considerable amount of hair and now look 40. Although I don't have bald spots, the top of my head is quite thin and my hairline is running away. I've had 3 PRP treatments spaced 6 weeks and have had a laser hat used for 30 minutes 3 times a week. I don't think it's changed a thing. Money is no issue, but having hair is. I am in need of a solution as I can't really afford to go bald.
Thank you for your question. You submitted your question without a photo. You're describing in the details of your question that you are 20 years old, you started losing hair at 16, and although you don't have any bald spots, you have very thin hair and that your hairline is receding and that you look like you're 40. Further, you are describing the treatment strategy that you've employed so far, which is 3 PRP injections spaced about 6 weeks apart and laser therapy for 30 minutes 3 times a week. And you feel that you've not gotten any improvement and you're looking for some potential options to help you deal with your hair loss. Well, I can certainly share with you my impressions of your situations in the absence of a physical examination and more detail about your family and medical history. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system we developed that evolved out of hair transplant surgery using PRP and acellular matrix to help men and women with genetic pattern hair loss non-surgically. And we have treated patients from all over the world, and we have extensive experience, and we were amongst the first, and at this point, probably the most experienced with this regenerative medicine technology, which you have been trying to apply for yourself, and with the knowledge gained from 7 to 8 years of experience, I can give you some guidance as to what your clinical picture is. So to begin with, the measure of success in your situation is probably looking at things from a very short-term perspective. If you've had an injection done every 6 weeks of PRP, it is your doctor's recommendation for this, but further, your doctor should give you some guidance as to what you can expect after these treatments. You know, when we were first using platelet-rich plasma and this material called acellular matrix or extracellular matrix, which is a wound healing material, we were using this for patients during hair transplant surgery. And what we learned over time was that thinning hair actually became thicker, in addition to helping the grafts heal better and the donor area heal better. But the results we saw was a year after the injections. Now, over the course of several years since, I've looked at examples of patients over different protocols that we ultimately developed for men of different ages and women of different ages and other different clinical profiles. What we have learned over time is essentially to develop further a classification system. And that classification system essentially allows me to determine the relative aggressiveness of a person's hair loss. So PRP has been established after many years of my colleagues dismissing it as a viable way to help treat hair loss. The challenge that I feel with PRP is the longevity of its effect. And certainly, when somebody has a very aggressive pattern of hair loss, the stimulatory effect of the PRP may still be overwhelmed by the genetics. And this is important. When we look at a patient, with the experience, we first developed protocols and systems and processes to customize the treatments for every patient. And I would assert that PRP alone is not going to be as effective as PRP with acellular matrix, but that still may not be effective enough in your case, and I'll explain further. When we looked at our patients, and we, of course, benefited from consistent high rates of success of a wide range of patients of different ages and different degrees of hair loss and different rates of progression. But there would be patients who didn't respond. Patients who we got maybe an initial response and then they started to lose hair. And I looked at these patients from a viewpoint of what else could I have done to help these patients in addition to this significant treatment of using platelet-rich plasma and acellular matrix, which has essentially created a new category of regenerative medicine technology. Well, then, looking at certain groups, and the group that I think that applies to you is a young person with early age of onset with rapid progression. In my practice, when I meet someone like yourself, one of the things that I really strongly recommend is a DHT blocker, a drug like finasteride. Why is that? Well, with the benefit of experience, we've learned that even patients who can do well with the stimulatory effect of hair regeneration, helping a patient who has relatively high DHT sensitivity by diminishing the amount of DHT with finasteride has a potential value. Now, this is the hard lesson to understand, to recognize, and to acknowledge, is that no treatment is a cure. Whether you're using minoxidil or finasteride, hair regeneration or hair transplant, none of these are cures. These are all management strategies to help people maximize coverage. Why I also recommend finasteride is that in a situation where somebody has such aggressive progression, there is a value in the finasteride slowing down that progression, and then there's the synergy of a treatment like hair regeneration, which can stimulate the growth. You combine a prolongation with the stimulation and you get better coverage. However, there is going to be a certain expiration of all of these modalities where you will eventually lose the rest of your hair. What my strategy is with my patients is to delay that as long as possible, delay the need for transplantation as long as possible. So I think that if you are very committed to dealing with this genetic situation, discuss with your doctor the use of a DHT blocker. Discuss with your doctor this strategy and where is the horizon when it comes to these PRP injections. A lot of people are coming to us after undergoing multiple PRP injections and feeling like they're not getting benefit, similar to yourself. And I think why a lot of my colleagues are not quite there in terms of experience, they don't know how to recognize the effectiveness as well as how to space the treatments in a way that will be optimal. We have already done that to this point with our systems for different patients of different classifications. Again, as I said earlier, we have a classification system based on gender, age, age of onset of hair loss, rate of progression, degree of progression, previous medical treatments and relative success with those treatments, as well as other medical variables. So there's a lot of moving parts, but ultimately there is a certain common pathway, or I should say a common characteristic, which defines and distinguishes someone like yourself, young onset, rapid progression. Let's contrast that with someone who's in their 40s, who started losing hair in their late 30s, and they only have a moderate amount of hair loss. They have a relative different level of DHT sensitivity. They have a different genetic program. So these are important variables. And so I think it's important to either discuss with the doctor who's doing the treatments for you or another hair loss specialist about a strategy to help maximize your coverage for as long as possible. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.